89.3 and 88.5 YesFM. Also broadcasting on the internet at yeshome.com and on your smartphone through TuneIn Radio and Wonder Radio.
Spirit Song Festival coming up June the 27th through the 29th. And one of the bands that'll be there is Building 429. And the lead singer, Building 429, is Jason. And we have him on the phone line. Hi, Jason.
Hey, April. How are you today?
I am well. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. Doing great. Just getting woke up and finding out where we're playing today, riding in on the bus. I think we're in someplace. I'll figure it out in a little bit.
Actually, I was kind of taking a look at your tour, and it looks like you guys might be in Decatur, Illinois today.
Well, so. I know that there's a Starbucks in Decatur, so it's going to work out perfect.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So, yeah. So, currently you guys are on the Gimme Jesus tour, correct?
That's right. That's right. You know, this tour has been amazing. Having time to play, to hang out with guys like Rhett Walker. And honestly, man, I got to say, this new band that's just coming out called Finding Favor, these guys are, like, legit. I mean, I'm really impressed with their songs, their songwriting. The guys are so kind and so they had genuine, you know what I mean? And so I expect big things out of them. Of course, you know, Toby's kind of picked them up and put them on his label. So, I mean, of course, anything Toby puts his hand on usually works pretty well. But I'm really impressed with these guys.
Excellent. Very good. Well, I'm so glad that Toby is working with them. Yeah, we've been hearing a little bit of a buzz about them, so that's awesome. Very good. Very, very good. Well, of course, you're on this tour, but one of the stops that you'll be making during the summer is, well, obviously several stops during the summer, is some of the music festivals, one of which is Spirit Song. And have you played Spirit Song before?
You know what? I'm pretty sure that at some point in our history we have. It's just they all start running together after a while. I'll tell you this, though. We're really, really excited about it. The lineup that night is amazing. I always have this bad habit of staring at different, like, specific, like shows, especially when they're, like, at, you know, outdoor, like, parks and stuff like that. Man, I love that kind of stuff. So we're really looking forward to it.
Excellent. Very good. And you guys are actually playing on the 28th, which is right in the middle of it. So looks like some great lineups as far as you guys, who you're playing with, and then, of course, the other 2 days as well. So should be a lot of fun.
Well, I mean, those festival things are really, in fact, I'd say that's what Building 429, we have built our, what we do based off of interaction. So anytime we have an opportunity to play a festival where there's people out in front of us, a large group of people, where there's an opportunity for us to kind of lead people to Jesus, man, that's our thing. So we look forward to, we really enjoy making records, but we look forward much more to playing outdoor shows, even though the crew absolutely hates the outdoor shows where it gets all hot and sweaty, but we really do enjoy those.
Ah, poor crew. You got to give them props, though, for everything that they do for you guys behind the scenes.
They are rock stars, and we're going to make sure we grill out for those boys for sure that day. So they'll get some good food out of it, I promise you that.
Excellent. Now, do you guys get an opportunity to enjoy the park at all with it being at Kings Island? I mean, there's, like, several coasters and all sorts of rides. Do you get a chance to do that? And if you do you like coasters?
Yeah, do we like coasters? The answer to that question is absolutely. Do we like the lines that you have to wait in to ride coasters? Absolutely not. you know, when I was younger, it used to be really cool to go stand in line for 2 hours to ride a 60-second ride. Now, the older I get, the more it's like, you know what? If I don't have, like, a pass to the front of the line, I think I'm just going to chill on the bus that day.
I can't sit there and blame you.
I know, it's so lazy. Isn't that lazy? That's so lazy.
Yeah. Yeah, well, with the way the weather has been, if this summer is anything like last summer, you know, you kind of almost want to chill out on the bus. I mean, otherwise you might pass out a heat stroke or something like that waiting some of those lines.
Well, and that's true. I mean, I'll say that, too, about our show. I don't think those people who have seen our show as of lately, they know that it's pretty intense. And
yeah.
So for us, man, we got to, it's funny, I mean, I used to go out and go running 5 or 6 miles every day, like literally, we'd do that every day, and we'd do CrossFit workouts and all that stuff, and my body's just got to where it's hard for me to keep up if I do all that and try to play a show that night. So we have to be a little bit more careful now, because the first time we played the show, I remember coming off the stage and looking at Jesse, and Jesse's like, ooh, both of us were kind of like out of breath. And we were like, what's going on? He's like, well, you're playing an hour and a half now, stupid. That's kind of our thing, man. We're kind of like waking up and realizing, oh, wow, we have to play longer now, you know?
Yeah. Well, I would think that now, I mean, that you are playing longer sets, you could just use that as your workout. I mean, especially you guys are like all over the place. You know, yeah. I'm sure you're going to be breaking out in sweat and be drenched by the time that you're done, especially if you're out in warm weather.
Well, I'll tell you, we got to do a lot of dry cleaning. There's no doubt about that. We do a lot of dry cleaning, that's for sure.
Oh, wow. I just imagine your bills.
Oh, yeah. It's not fun. It has to be done because you don't want to, we don't like being stinky either, so lots of dry cleaning.
Yep. There you go. Well, we're excited about your new album coming out. That's coming out on June the 4th called We Won't Be Shaken. So tell us about that.
You know what? We Won't Be Shaken is, you know, we actually were just talking to everybody, all the guys, all of our crew, and everybody's right here in the front lounge while I'm doing this interview, which means they get to hear me say stupid things and laugh at me. But so we were just talking about, like where we are building 429 right now. Like, we were really about to walk in and do some of the things that we've always dreamed of doing. You know, like, we're about to headline some major festivals. We're talking about just like the pinnacle achievement type things, and I really do believe that We Won't Be Shaken is one of our pinnacle achievements as a record. I mean, we really did know exactly what we were trying to accomplish. This record is really about being bold in our faith and being confident that God is who He says He is. I think it's also one of those records where we can kind of, we're going to be able to earmark it and say that one was the one that really we finally hit all of our markers on. And so, yeah, We Won't Be Shaken. I mean, this world is crazy right now, and there's a lot of crazy things going on, but we made a record that really was talking about how we can be confident that God is unchanging. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. He's been faithful, so He's going to be faithful again, and how we can stand boldly. And, and we actually pretty upfront take on some subjects that are a little bit scary, and that's what We Won't Be Shaken is all about. That song has really been resonating because it's a song that's based out of Psalm 62, which basically says the Lord is my rock, my refuge, my shelter, and my fortress where I will never be shaken. And when He is our rock and He is our refuge and He is our fortress, then we have confidence. But when our own, you know, beliefs and our own confidence and our own strength is our rock and refuge, well, we know how weak we can be. So then we do get shook up. So this record is definitely going to be an earmark for us. I'm really excited about it. It comes out June the 4th. It's called We Won't Be Shaken. June the 4th, We Won't Be Shaken. June the 4th, We Won't Be Shaken. There you go.
Now, I know a lot of people are looking forward to it, but listening to the song specifically itself, to me, it seems like it's just like, man, this is our anthem. This is what we're all about, you know, and obviously you were saying a lot about that too, but yeah, it's one of those that you can't deny, and certainly, you know, I think a lot of people are going to appreciate the fact that, you know, despite all the craziness that's been going on, especially within the last year or two, they can take this and you know, have that when things are absolutely going insane.
Yeah, I mean, again, that was the idea. I mean, it's funny because when we wrote the song, we were just thinking about, at that time, a year and a half ago when we wrote the song, I mean, things were kind of crazy then, but boy, have things even funny that it seems even more out of control in this last, you know, in this last 6 months. I mean, it's been kind of scary almost, you know, but it's funny because it's amazing how God gives you something long before the moment that you need it. And I would feel like We Won't Be Shaken was given to us long before we needed it. And now it's our, you know, it's our anthem. It's right. So even, you know, it's becoming other people's anthems, but it's really our anthem, even when crazy stuff go on. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely. Be encouraged. I don't know if you saw the news this morning, but they were putting the spire on top of the new World Trade Center building in New York City. So that was pretty exciting to see that, you know, as far as, you know, just kind of being a symbol of hope after what happened, you know, with 9/11. You know, what are some of your thoughts on that?
You know what? I think it's amazing. I think that, you know, I think more than anything, I think it's we're such a blessed country, and I think that it's an opportunity for us to kind of go, wow, look at the means that we've been given to build. That's a rebuild when everything's broken down. There are a lot of countries that don't have that. There are a lot of places where culture is that it's constantly just shambles, and I think that we kind of need to remember the blessing that we live our life under. I think we need to rejoice over the fact that in this country we can worship God freely. And I think also be confident. You know, I think that one of the things that we talk about in our show is we talk a lot about how, why would people want the Jesus that you portray? Is He weak? Is He feeble? Is He desperate? Or is the Jesus that you portray the Jesus that is come into your life and therefore has made you more than a conqueror? And for us, I think as believers in this country, I think that we look around and we see this country spinning somewhat away from faith. But in a lot of ways, it's because we've gone silent. In a lot of ways, it's because we're scared to talk about the truth. And I think that if we can kind of display the love of Jesus, which is a love that is full of grace, full of mercy. There is no line in the sand of people that we won't reach out and try to love. I think if we could display that love of Jesus, I think people would want it. And I think we could also display the confidence and the boldness of the disciples who, after seeing Jesus resurrected, were willing to go to death because they knew he was exactly who he says he was. I think that people would be more inclined to be interested in this Jesus instead of the Jesus that's desperate, hurting. And, you know, we got to stop living in the past tense. I think it's time for us to live in the future tense and in the present tense. And that's really kind of our hope as we move forward.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Once again, we were talking to Jason, lead singer of the group Building 429, currently on the Give Me Jesus tour. And then, of course, there'll be a Spirit Song Festival, which is happening at Kings Island. And their specific day will be June the 28th. The actual festival goes from June the 27th through the 29th. People can check that out on our concert beat at yeshome.com once we get the new site up and running on Monday. So, Jason, before we let you go, is there anything that we can be specifically praying for you guys about as you're on the road launching the new album?
You know what? Yeah, that'd be great. I'd love for you guys to pray for our families.
Okay.
We all have wives. I have two kids. Aaron has three kids. And I think that, every 3 years, when we launch a new record, we go insane with touring. And so this year is no different. We're doing about 30 days almost straight of on the road, hitting every major market in the United States of America, just as an effort to kind of let people know what's going on and what God's doing in our lives. And our wives are committed to it. Our families are committed to it. That doesn't make it any easier. And I think also, as you're praying for our families, pray for our health. It's a lot of sleepless nights, a lot of red-eye airplane, air flights. And we talk about this a lot, but, we can play music anytime, even when we're sick, even when we're tired, doesn't matter. But it's awful hard for the three of us who are singers to sing when we get exhausted. It's kind of hard to man up and push through that. So just pray for an extra portion of grace on our vocal cords and on our bodies, and hopefully we can kind of push through this and go out there and get people excited about this new record, We Won't Be Shaken.
Awesome. Very good. Well, let's go to the Lord in prayer real quick here. Lord Jesus, we just thank you for Jason and the rest of the guys who make up Building 429. We're so excited for what you have ahead of them as far as this tour that they're currently on, and of course the summer music festivals with a new album coming out, Lord. We just pray right now over their families as they are separated from them, that you would just be protective over their families, their wives, their kids, Lord. Be protective over them on the road, not just with like things like traveling mercies and all the stuff that goes on behind putting a concert on, Lord, but then also too just for their health, Lord. So many times we hear behind the scenes stuff, but we just really, aren't focusing on some of that, and sometimes we need to, Lord. So I just lift up their health to you right now, and just give them that extra push when things seem to be kind of tough and they feel like, man, I just can't do this. We just thank you and we praise you, Lord, in your name. Amen.
Oh, man, thank you so much. Amen. That's awesome, man. Thank you for that prayer. Appreciate that.
Yeah, no problem. Thank you so much for joining us, and you guys have a great concert tonight, and we look forward to seeing you at Spirit Song Festival.
All right. Well, come on back. We'll be grilling somewhere. Come see us.
Absolutely. That sounds great.
All righty. Yes, FM.